Hi Angelo, so sorry about the delay getting this reading to you. My apologies. Okay, so you're mentioning that you tried to communicate with her, but there was no response. So we're doing an infinity spread. That is the divine partnership spread with the twin flame reading. So we'll start with the divine partnership, and hopefully that can, give you some answers as to what she's experiencing currently and your next right action. So I'm going to be using the John Holland for the main energy, and I'll be pulling three cards for each position for clarification. So nine cards feminine, nine masculine, and then three for each position. So it's going to be a lengthy video, so get comfy. Whoa, holy moly. Okay, I think that's good. All right, so beginning with the masculine, how you view the relationship with the feminine, solar plexus chakra. So this talks about finding strength and courage, determination and willpower in order to move through something. You feel something is holding you back, so you feel either you feel strong by this relationship or that you're trying to find courage in order to deal with something. Queen of Cups, King of Wands, wow, and Ten of Cups. So you see her as the Queen of Cups, this open, receptive, loving woman, very generous with her love, an open receptacle. Psychically intuitive, and it could represent a water sign. Then we have the King of Wands, and a couple of weeks ago, the divine masculines were being represented as the King of Wands, being the center of the sun, being powerful, lit up, or it could represent a fire sign. But it's, you standing in your power, finding that strength, courage, and determination in order to move forward towards a union, your love of your life. And what do you want? You want the Ten of Cups. It's that completion. It is a happily ever after. It is abundance of love. So you feel very strongly a deep love for your divine feminine. And she makes you feel powerful and strong. And you want this happy ending. So it's nearing completion. There's this sense that this energy is coming towards you. This is what you would like to have. Okay, so next is how does she view the relationship? Nice, magician. Master manifester. She is conscious. She is connected through her crown chakra to source. She realized that she is able to manifest her reality. So she brings thoughts from the ether, from the collective, and makes them a reality in the 3D. So there's a sense that she's trying to manifest her life, create her life in her image, the way she wants it done. So there's a grounded energy here. So she views this relationship as empowering her in order to make something manifest in the 3D, or it could be that you are enlightening her, making her aware in terms of her consciousness. But let's see what else. Sun, the Wheel of Fortune, and Six of Pentacles. So the Sun card is the masculine energy. Over here, you're being represented as the center of the Sun, but it is the best major arcana to get. It is the most positive card. It is return to innocence. It is abundance coming towards her. It is dreams being manifested. It is a new beginning, but it's a masculine energy. Then we got the Wheel of Fortune. This is about major changes, significant changes taking place in her environment, not only externally, but internally as well. So there's this real shaking up kind of energy right now. This also talks about, good fortune, good luck, and a completion of a stage. It is a 5 to 10 year cycle. So it's a completion of that and a beginning. So there's a major transformation happening, and standing in her light. It's her time to shine. Then the Six of Pentacles. This is about being open to sharing, giving and receiving in the 3D. So there's a sense that when she thinks of you, there's an opening in her that she wants some kind of exchange in the 3D. So there is, a major awakening and awareness going on within her currently. The wheel of change is occurring, and it's stirring up a lot of things within her. And it's opening her up in the 3D as well as spiritually. Okay, so what are you resisting? Wow, Four of Wands. Twin Flame calling card for the John Holland deck. Somehow you are resisting this. It's foundations and achievements. It is making your dreams manifest. And it has to do with your highest visions and goals, the things that, your highest passions. And in attaining that. So it's harvest. It's, really grounding your dreams in reality. And that's what this magician is about. It's about grounding dreams in reality in the 3D. But it's an arrival, a completion, and the beginning. It's like buying a house for the first time, feeling like you've arrived, and then it's a beginning as well, because you have your entire life ahead of you yet. But it is you and your twin coming together and finding peace and relaxation and finally enjoying life. Ten of Pentacles. Wow. Wow. Divine Masculine Twin Flame. And wow. The Ace of Pentacles. So you, even though it's in your resisting position, maybe that resisting energy is coming from the feminine, but you see this ultimate dream, this ultimate happy ending three times. You got the Ten of Cups, completion, happy ending. This is another 10, completion. But it is the final resting place. It is that retirement. It is building up that wealth and not having to worry about money anymore. You're just enjoying your family, rest and relaxation. It is further into the future than this card. This is what you desire. It's you want that twin flame connection. You are awake and aware in your divinity, in your authenticity. And you see that dream being manifested in the future and you want it. Then we got the Ace of Pentacles, and that's, that seed being planted, that beginning of this. So this reduces to one, and then one over here, so an 11. Between is the Divine Masculine you. And I made this card to represent the Twin Flame only. So you are offering either at this happy ending, this blissful state, this completion to the feminine, and she's resisting it, is what I'm getting from this. This is a 3D offer, brand new start in the 3D world, and it's being offered from you, this divine masculine energy, twin flame, 1111, all over the place, but it's being resisted. So I'm going to pull one card from the Osho Zen Tarot for just an additional message that I want to read to you. You're coming in very powerful this time, Angelo. Okay, so let me just give this a shuffle. So also, the sun is 19 and it reduces to 1. So we got a 1-1 here, which is an 11. And, sorry, the Wheel of Fortune is a 10 as well, which reduces to a 1. So 1-1-1. Okay. Wow. 1-1-1-1-1-1. crazy. Okay, so it's aloneness, the hermit. So this is a reason for the resistance. So this would either represent your energy or hers. So I'm going to read that to you. When there is no significant other in our lives, we can either be lonely or enjoy the freedom that solitude brings. When we find no support among others for our deeply felt truths, we can either feel isolated and bitter or celebrate the fact that our vision is strong enough even to survive the powerful human need for approval of family, friends, and colleagues. If you are facing such a situation now, be aware of how you are choosing to view your aloneness. And take responsibility for the choice you have made. The humble figure in this card glows with the light that emanates from within. One of Gautama Buddha's most significant contributions to the spiritual life of humankind was to insist to his disciples, be a light unto yourself. Ultimately, each of us must develop within ourselves the capacity to make our way through the darkness without any companion, map, or guide. So, you know, I'm getting the sense that, you know, this resistance is because she's on a spiritual journey of enlightenment, coming into her own. The magician is a number one. It's that beginning. It's that first card after the fool's card, the beginning of the fool's journey, you know. So it's almost like it's a beginning kind of feeling to it. All right, so what is she resisting? Balance, justice card, 11. This talks about having balance in all aspects of your life, mentally, emotionally, physically, and spiritually. And there's a sense that karma is coming back to her in a good way, but let's see why she's resisting that. Whoa, 10 of swords, another 10, holy moly. Devil card, and another 10, the 10 of wands, reduce to an 11, 11, 11, with the devil in the middle. All right, so she's resisting cutting some negative aspects out of her life. The Ten of Swords is the dark night of the soul. It is being left for dead in the middle of the road with 10 swords in her back. But it's a 10. It's a completion of feeling this way, right? And what is she, you know, resisting cutting out of her life? It's the devil. It's a codependent relationship. It's an addiction. It's some... she's placing too much emphasis on the material world. And she's resisting cutting it out, so it's causing an imbalance. The Ten of Wands is that same kind of energy. But it has to do with taking on too many burdens, too many responsibilities. It is, again, getting close to giving up. It is... a 10, so it's a completion. It's an ending to feeling this way. But again, she's resisting putting an end to this. She's exhausted. She is feels stabbed in the back. She's chained to a codependent relationship or an addiction of some kind. It has to do with the material world. And this is piercing thoughts. It's nightmares. It is... inability to sleep. Same thing over here, dreading that alarm clock ringing. So she is going through a major... she's under a lot of stress, trying to find her balance. But only she can release this devil card. And once she does, then there will be a rebirth. This is about a rebirth. And same with this. It's releasing those attachments to the 3D world. So this is, again, what she is resisting. So your message from your higher self. Surrender. This is the hangman. This is letting go of control. It is seeing things from a different perspective, but this card shows up when there's significant changes going on. So Spirit is asking you to release yourself and pause and heal for reflection. Okay, one moment. Sorry about that, but kids need attention. My apologies. Okay, so I'll just give that a quick shuffle. So your message from your higher self is surrender. Or wait, is that... Yeah, that's yours. So three clarifiers. Magician again. One, a four, and the Knight of Swords. So the Magician, this is about the master manifestor trying to make something reality, manifest an idea, grounding it in the reality. Remember, she got that in her, how she views a relationship. So it's kind of a shared energy. So you want to make something happen. And Spirit is asking you to surrender and let go of control. The Four of Swords is about retreat. It's a pause. It's moving away from negative energy, negative thoughts, negative situations. Very similar to the Hangman card. This is a pause, reevaluation, reflection. Whereas this is more of a healing energy. It's healing your heart after a difficult period of time. So, and it's a grounding energy as well. It's a four, so you want to ground something into the 3D. So you're being asked to pause and think things through and have a clear perspective, see things from a different angle, let go of control. So the Knight of Swords could represent an air sign, but this is a sudden energy. It's he's a champion, he's a rebel without a cause, but it is wanting to express yourself, communication. That's what sword is all about. It's air, communication. So you know, you want to move forward with that. There's the Knight is a forward movement, so you really want to make something manifest. You want to speak your truth. But then we got this Four of Swords here, and the main card is the Hangman. So Spirit is asking you, or your higher self is asking you, to surrender, let go of control, and pause. And from there, you will find the answers. Okay, so for a message from the higher self, from the Feminine, Five of Swords. So this is walking away from conflict. It's a lot of negative energy in her environment, and that makes sense because she has a Ten of Swords and the Devil and the Ten of Wands. So she's really beaten up, and she wants to move towards the candle, towards the light. Three of Wands, Three of Pentacles, and Ace of Wands. Okay, so the Three of Wands is all about making a decision based on this spark of inspiration, the Ace of Wands, and the decision to move forward, the green light, go. The decision to move forward wasn't based on fear. It was based on your highest dreams, the Four of Wands. And the Three of Wands is that payoff coming back to you. It is, you know, the... putting effort into making this dream realized, and then there was a waiting period, but it's having energy coming back to you. It's having that, those seeds of intentions coming towards you. Then the Three of Pentacles, this is a grounding energy. This is putting work into the 3D in order to ground and a beginning. But it's also about, you know, having, you know, starting to see the fruits of your labor coming back. So she feels, you know, she has an idea, a spark, an inspiration. She wants a new beginning in life. She wants to start fresh, blank slate. And her higher self is telling her to go ahead and do that. Move away from this conflict, this battle. And again, it's a gift from the universe, but it's a brand new beginning, clean slate, go light. So her higher self is telling her it's go time. And she's, you know, there's a sense of enthusiasm and excitement when she thinks of this go light. And she either wants to ground this energy in the 3D, or she has already grounded it and she's feeling illuminated. She's feeling strong. So there's a sense that there's more work that needs to be made, but there's this illumination, and the illumination is a candle. It's a light. It's a very dim light. We want something like the Knight of Wands or the Page of Wands to really pour gasoline on that fire. Okay, so for your recent past, wow, universe card. So you've been through all the stages of the Fool's Journey, and you've come into this grand awakening. You've completed a massive journey of enlightenment. So you understand your place in the universe. You understand that the universe is you. You feel a sense of oneness and wholeness with everything. And once you've completed this massive journey, which could, you know, take up to, you know, 20 years or your entire life to complete, then the Fool's Journey begins again. So it's an ending, a completion, and a beginning again. So this is Spirit telling you, like giving you a really strong pat on the back and congratulating you for your efforts. Ace of Swords. The King of Air Swords and the Six of Wands. So the Ace of Swords is making a decision. It is standing in your truth. It is clarity of thought. It is cutting away the darkness, the barriers holding you back. And it's grounding an idea. So there's a sense that you're really standing in your truth right now. You're have clarity of thought. The King of Swords is the king of thought, mental control. He has control over his emotions. He is a doer. He makes plans. He sets those plans in motion, and he makes things happen. He's very authoritative. He's very respected. But the main important thing here is that he speaks his truth. He's one level up from this Knight of Swords, or two levels up from the Knight of Swords. This is the pinnacle of mental clarity and communication, especially with the Ace of Swords here and this completion card. You are so conscious, it's insane. You are awake, aware, and in control. Okay, so Six of Wands is success and victory. It is accomplishment. It is being rewarded for your efforts. It's people cheering for you. You're being seen as an example. They're attracted to your light. And here you are, the star in the sky, the universe. You are really shining above. And again, you're in your light here. But there's a strong silence here that is reflective of the feminine energy that's going on right now. The divine feminine as a collective is the one that is standing in her strength, very much like the King of Swords, but she's being kind of represented as Justice and this Ace of Swords, as well as the Queen of Swords. So there's this silent strength in her knowing as a collective, but you are bringing in this energy. There's almost this reverse polarity, you're almost taking on the feminine qualities as a divine masculine. And but she is still awakening. You're almost like, you are the one that is providing her with the information towards her awakening. You're guiding her in that direction. But there's a sense that she's really just kind of starting off on this journey. There's so many tens here. And then we got that magician card, that new beginning. It is like that spark of divinity, enlightenment. But you have completed that journey. You are standing in your power as the divine masculine twin flame. So you know your truth and you want to speak your truth. And this is in the recent past position. So there's a sense that you already did this. You spoke your truth. Right? And there was this completion of a cycle, major cycle. And the next step would be that Fool card, that new beginning. Okay, so for her recent past, wow, Ace of Swords, we got a mirroring effect. You got the Ace of Swords right here. This is more of like a feminine energy. She's standing there exposed. I don't know what that would mean, though. But here, Ace of Swords, decision, communication, cutting through the darkness, triumph and success. It is victory. It is an idea being grounded, but now we have a masculine energy, a masculine hand, clarity of thought, truth, whoa, justice card, page of wands, three of cups. So the justice card, it's coming up in what she's resisting. So there's a sense that this sword energy may have created an imbalance in her, or this could be karma coming back to her, showing her truth. She's naked here as well. So another feminine energy, naked with a sword. Very reflective of what's going on here. Can you still see that card? Yeah, so then we have the Page of Wands. So she represents gasoline being poured on the fire. It's an explosion of excitement, optimism, happiness, and it's directed towards that aha moment, that spark. So this is the actual go. This is the idea, that light going off. And this is actual movement forward. It is good news coming. It is being excited about this news that came in, this clarity of thought, this truth being expressed, this knowing. And pages are messengers, so it's about communication. But and it's coming in the past position. So she got a message, good news. It made her excited. But there's a sense, you know, that it could also mean that it cut away the darkness, cleared light to her truth so she can see her truth. Then the Three Cups is a union card. This is two people coming together to share love. The third energy is love. And it is true love. Because you know that it's true, because you know it makes you feel alive and excited like this. You can feel it moving through you, and it awakens you to this knowing that you're a part of something much bigger than yourself. So there's this sudden clarity and truth cutting through the darkness, a union, true love, unconditional love. Another 1, 1, 1, 11, 11. Interesting, 21 and 12. So you got 3, 3, 3. You wrote down a number sequence in the email. I can't remember what it was, but you're saying you're seeing a sequence of numbers. Okay, so your present position. Wow. intuition, high priestess. This could represent that you're psychically, intuitively connected. This could mean that you're going deep below the surface into the subconscious in order to find answers, which is very reflective of the hangman energy up here. You know, it's in the Knight of Swords. It's like going within, as well as the Four of Swords. It's going within, listening to your inner voice, your inner knowing, in order to find answers, your truth. It's a surrender. So currently, you're really tapped into this energy. This also represents the divine feminine in her spiritual form, in her 5D, coming in to the present moment to tell you that I am always with you in the 5D, even though I'm not with you in the 3D, I'm there, always connected. You are my mirror, the other part of my soul. We can never be alone. So usually when this card comes up, it's to offer reassurance. And the High Priest card, the Hierophant, would be the masculine energy offering reassurance as well. Two of Swords. Two Twos. Wow, the Universe card again. Another three. And then the Seven of Cups. Okay. So, the Two of Swords is the inability to move forward. Indecision. Two choices, both have far-reaching consequences. And so, because there is such a profound effect as a result of a decision that needs to be made, there is a stop. There's an inability to move forward until this decision is being made. So this is a reason why you are really going within and tapping into your inner knowing. To skip over to this one, this is a Seven of Cups. This is feeling like things may be just an illusion. Not knowing if it's your imagination or if it's real. It is also talking about going within, tapping into your inner knowing in order to find those answers. So it's a pause as well. It's an indecision, inability to make a clear choice because you just don't know it all yet. Here, the choice cannot be made. It's too massive of a decision. And then we have the world card, or universe card, right at the middle here. So there's this deep connection that you have with the universe in the 5D. Here's the universe right here. You know, you guys are connected through the 5D, through the source, through the universe. And here's the universe right smack in the middle of all of this confusion. It is clarity. It is truth. It is knowing. You've been through all the stages of the fool's journey. You have completed this journey in the past, and this energy is being brought into the future as well. So there's a sense that you have done your work, and this new beginning is in the future. So it all hangs on the balance of this decision that needs to be made. So I'm going to pull one card from the Osho Zen Tarot for that one, and I will read it to you. Here, very complex reading you got here. What additional messages do you have for this present position cards, please? Wow, Thunderbolt Tower. So yeah, I mean, this major decision here, obviously, is massive enough to create that tower effect. It's that thunderbolt. It is massive change, an ending to this massive cycle. So you're being asked to be the conscious observer, which is exactly what's going on here, to allow that tower to fall on its own without any influence from you. So it's almost like Source is asking you to really own this not knowing and not interacting, and you know, just be the observer while this process completes. It's like a crazy these four cards is saying the exact same thing as this card here. So let me read that to you. Okay, the card shows a tower being burned, destroyed, blown apart. A man and woman are leaping from it, not because they want to, but because they have no choice. In the background is a transparent, meditating figure representing the witnessing consciousness. You might be feeling pretty shaky right now, as if the earth is rocking beneath your feet. Your sense of security is being challenged, and the natural tendency is to try to hold on to whatever you can. But this inner earthquake is both necessary and tremendously important. If you allow it, you will emerge from the wreckage stronger and more available for new experiences. After the fire, the earth is replenished. After the storm, the air is clear. Try to watch the destruction with detachment, almost as if it were happening to somebody else. Say yes, the process, by meeting halfway. So, yeah, being that conscious observer. But there's a sense that you are really tapped into your consciousness anyway. So it's just like confirmation to just continue to be in this state of knowing without any influence from you. When somebody is moving through the awakening process, the awakening stages, there's a tendency for someone who is awake to want to quicken their evolution. But that actually slows it down. When there's any kind of pressure from the outside world, it has a tendency to halt their evolution, their awakening. So they need to find their way on their own. So yeah, but the tower comes when you're least expected, and it's coming in your present position. So there's a sense that this decision is being made, and from it there will be this massive completion. But there's a feeling that this tower is an outside energy, and it's directly related to the devil and the Ten of Swords. So something is being cut away, an ego is being released, a rebirth. All right, I can't remember if I shuffled this in front of you. Okay, so moving on to her present position. The moon, yes, of course. She's facing her shadow aspect. So this could represent the feminine quality, moon, whereas masculine is the sun. But I really feel deeply that she is going through the dark night of the soul right now as we speak. And it's a nine, so it's coming to the end of that. But she needs to pass through that veil of darkness before she can really truly come into her knowing. All these things that she's been holding back, ignoring, are now all coming to the light, to the surface, and is being represented as the tower. So you're sensing this tower energy. So three cards, please. Six of Cups, Nine of Swords, another nine. Whoa, Ace of Cups. Okay, so the Nine of Swords, let's go right to the middle here. Nine and a nine. There are two cards that represent the nearing, the completion, the ending of. The nine is also a dark night of the soul. It is staying up at night, nightmares, night terrors, inability to sleep. It is this energy, but you're not down for the count. It's not completely over yet. So she is really experiencing a lot of darkness in her life right now, and she can't sleep, and there's a lot of guilt. Fear is completely controlling her life, and the only way that she is going to make it, you know, to end this cycle is to go through this transformation. So, I was going to say maybe I'll read it to you, but I don't want your reading to be all me just reading. So let's continue on. The Six of Cups is a reunion, somebody from your past coming back to you. It is somebody that you hold very dear to your heart, somebody that makes you feel innocent, pure, love. And it is also having fond memories of somebody and holding on to those memories. But for some reason, it's creating this anxiety, this stress, this inability to move forward. Very reflective of this energy here. It's like the prison of the mind. It's a self-imposed prison. And she can release herself once she walks through that darkness. So there's like this gate separating this loving energy. So once she's able to move through that veil, then love will come in. The Ace of Cups only shows up when you are... you've healed your heart, you've let go of the past, which is this is past lives. This is also past life as well, but it's a love, it's a return. And when you've forgiven others and forgiven yourself, then and only then will your heart be truly open to accept love. So there's a sense that she wants a new beginning. This is her present position. She wants it, but she can't. She's consumed with fear. And she needs to go through the dark night of the soul. And like I said, you're sensing that. Highly intuitive. And again, this is a reversal of what I'm seeing for the divine feminine and divine masculine. It is the masculine that seems to be carrying this energy of the dark night of the soul, and the feminine is in her, you know, completion stage. Why can't I find the end? Sorry about that. Okay, so your final outcome. Nine of Pentacles, another nine, another completion. This is that harvest abundance coming back to you. You were waiting for that return. You wanted the Ten of Pentacles, and there's a sense that that's coming to you. It's ripeness. It's the fruit falling from the tree. It is grounded energy on major level. It is getting to that point where you don't have to worry about money anymore. There's just a nice, even flow of exchange. But it is, you know, feeling accomplished in the 3D. Nice. Eight of Wands, Three of Swords, and whoa, Five of Cups. So the Eight of Wands could represent communication, literally, by phone or text messaging. But it also represents Cupid's arrows as well. So it's an energy coming towards you. It's love coming towards you. And this represents that energy too as well. It's abundance coming towards you. The Ace of Wands Eight of Wands also talks about reaching for your highest dreams, your highest goals, your highest visions, and having them realized. So it's that energy coming back to you. This abundance is coming towards you. Then we got the Three of Swords and the Five of Cups. And this is like kind of a feminine energy here. So there's a sense that you know, she's going to heal her heart and let go of the pain. But she's going to be coming towards you in this broken state. After going through the dark night of the soul and releasing this, there's a sense that she will be in your 3D, but in this broken state. That's kind of what I'm picking up here. You are a very grounded energy. And it's almost like you're using that energy to heal her. So I'm going to pull a card from the Osho Zen. Very complicated reading. All right. Whoa, Five of Pentacles. So this talks about feeling locked out. So this child doesn't realize that this lock is not hitched, so he can just take the lock off and walk out. So there's a return to innocence and a feeling of being left out in the cold. So I don't know. So I'm just going to leave that for... I'm going to see what the other cards have to say as well. Okay, so from the message from the universe, obstacles and challenges, the Five of Wands. So this isn't meant as a large obstacle. It's actually just a very short step across this void here. It's not a big deal. These challenges are meant to... make the light shine brighter on you. So there's a sense of competition, rivals in your environment. Hermit. The Divine Feminine Twin Flame. And the Lover's card, Union. Twin Flame Union. Hermit card is somebody who has... who's retreated from society, who has realized that they've been conditioned their entire life. And so it's that detachment. It is cutting away the devil and all material attachments and going on a journey of self-discovery. And then coming back and sharing your wisdom with others, but it's finding that light within and shining it brightly in order to draw others out of the darkness. Then we got the Divine Feminine Twin Flame, but it's showing up on your side. You have the Divine Masculine on your side in what your resisting position, and here she's showing up on your side. So it's not on her side, which is telling me that she's not in that state just yet, but that there's that Twin Flame connection shared between the two of you. But there's obstacles stopping this union from happening. The Lover's card, I made this card to represent the twin flame union, that connection. But it is an actual union. It is the longing, the wanting, the yearning for union with your twin flame. So I'm getting here that, you know, you're in this hermit state of aloneness and you're on a journey of self-discovery and finding your light within and shining it bright. Trying to make yourself be known. But I'm seeing this, because it's a message from the universe, I'm seeing this as a confirmation that there is a divine twin flame connection here. And to continue to work on your spirituality, your inner knowing, and shine that bright as brightly as possible, and that will attract your divine feminine towards you, your twin flame. Okay, message from the universe for her. Eight of Wands. So that's this card right here. It's the Cupid's arrow. So it's almost like you're sending out these Cupid arrows towards your feminine. And she's receiving that on a 5D level. So there's good, you know, this beautiful manifested energy is coming towards her. And it could ultimately mean... communication between the two of you, but I'm also getting it as synchronicities from spirit that is awakening her, like number sequences. Wow, the High Priestess again, the Page of Swords, and Judgment. Big energies here. So High Priestess, this is this card here. It's tapping into your intuition, your inner knowing. So there's a sense that she's really doing her work on a subconscious level. She's trying to really connect with her intuition and seeing signs that's kind of helping her awaken. That's what this card is. It's judgment. It is that grand awakening. I was hoping to see this card on her side. So it is realizing that your entire life has just been a movie being played on a screen in your mind. None of it is real. It's just a projection. And so awakening to that, awakening to the conditioning, awakening to the ego, and releasing the ego. Grand, grand awakening. She is just starting to come into this now. So, yeah. You are so awake. You're grounded. You're all that. But she is just starting to. The Page of Swords, again, that's communication. It is clarity of thought. It is wanting to speak your truth, communicating your truth. But again, it's also messages, synchronicities. I'm getting a real deep feeling of synchronicities with these four cards, because it has to do with your awakening going within and that energy coming towards her from the universe. And it's awakening her to it. Awakening her to the truth. Okay, so your energy that's surrounding you. Moving on, Six of Swords. So this could represent her energy or an energy in your immediate environment. But this is making the decision to cut negative people, negative thinking, all of it out of your life, and move towards the things that make you feel good. So it's that ultimate decision. The Eight of Cups is showing up first, and then the Nine of Pentacles, and then the Four of Pentacles. So, the Eight of Cups is a very similar image to the, energy to this. So this is has to do with thoughts, negative thoughts and energy, whereas this Eight of Cups is emotional abuse, emotional baggage, people trying to control you by manipulating you. And finally deciding to walk away from that. So these two energies are walking away. And they're both masculine energy. So you, there's a sense of a masculine energy walking towards their higher purpose on a journey of self-discovery. But this could definitely represent the feminine deciding to walk away from that negativity, that devil card. Now we got the Nine of Pentacles, and it's a feminine energy, but you received it, Nine of Pentacles, you received this card as an outcome, and this is a masculine energy. So there's a sense of her needing to find her independence, freeing herself from this negative energy, this masculine energy. And there's a sense of being closed off, not allowing that in order to finally clear it from her surrounding, her energy field. Now, this could also represent you being on that pilgrimage and turning towards her. You view her as this material or 3D abundance, like that arrival, harvest, the fruit falling from the tree, but she's being closed off. You can read it many different ways. Oops, sorry. All right. So next is, what is the energy surrounding her? Another six. So it's a mirroring. She got a six here and a six here. Third eye chakra. So it's her energy surrounding her. So there's a sense that you're connected on the 5D through the third eye. But let's see what else. Wow, Four of Wands, Seven of Swords, and Page of Cups. Okay, so you got the Four of Wands in the resisting position. So now she's sensing that energy in her environment, that Four of Wands, that wanting that completion. So she's getting messages, like I said, through the 5D. As the High Priestess, she is getting those messages, visions from you. But then we got the Seven of Swords, which is stopping it or creating mental conflict, almost like that prison of the mind feeling. It's not knowing if you're being told the entire truth. It's questioning. It is feeling deceived, like you don't know the entire truth. So that is kind of blocking her. And then we got the Page of Cups. This is the beginning of love. It is another page. It is communicating your love. So it's an external environment. So there's a sense that in her mind's eye, she sees this happy ending, 11-11 connection. And she is getting messages of love from you through this third eye connection, the 5D, as well as through her heart chakra. Or it could literally mean messages from you being sent to her. But there's a sense of deception. She doesn't know if she's being deceived. There's this mental noise that is stopping her from fully opening and receiving that 11-11 twin flame union. Okay, so what do you fear? Seven of Pentacles, patience and planning. Wow, again, we always see this with the feminine twin flame. So this is putting a lot of work into the 3D and waiting for that harvest, that return, patience. Usually when this card turns up, it means that the wait is almost over. So we got the Strength card, the Fool card, and wow, the Knight of Cups. Beautiful. So yeah, you're waiting for that return, or maybe you're fearful that that wait, you know, that time of fruition will not come. The Strength card is very reminiscent of what's going on in your how you view the love and relationship. You're trying to find strength and courage in order to deal with the situation. So it's using love, kindness, and compassion rather than will and determination to have this brand new beginning. This is the beginning of the Fool's journey. I was waiting for this card to show up, and it's beautiful that it's showing up in your fear position. You fear this beginning is not going to happen. You got the Universe card twice. The next step was the Fool card. And what is it that you want to move towards? You want to be the Knight of Cups and offer your love to your twin flame. And again, this is a yearning card. This is a longing for union. You want to express it. The connection isn't grounded as of yet. All right, so what does the feminine fear? Wow, the Six of Cups, the twin flame. Of course she fears it. You got it in message from the universe, right? As well as the twin flame. So she fears this. Of course she does. Queen of Swords. The Five of Wands. And the Seven of Pentacles. Reflective energy again. So the Queen of Swords is speaking her truth. She's afraid to speak her truth. The Five of Wands is this card right here, obstacles and challenges. So the inability, it's like a total reflection of these cards. What the universe is telling you is reflected in her fears. That she's afraid of this union. That's why it's not moving forward. That's why the obstacle is being presented. And that is the cause for this delay. You got the Seven of Pentacles in your fear position is being mirrored in her fear position. So this, the obstacle to the union is her inability to speak her truth because she's afraid of what this deep connection. That's amazing. All right, so this concludes the divine partnership aspect of the reading. Now we'll move on to the twin flame. So I'm just going to look at the bottom of the deck for the overall energy. No way. Ace of Pentacles. Brand new beginning, 3D world, a one. The two of you coming together to lay that foundation and start a life together in the 3D. So you got that, you got it with the Ten of Pentacles. I believe it's here. Yes, here it is. This is you offering the twin, your twin, this new beginning, this 11-11 connection. Seeing that completion, that ending, that beautiful twin flame connection. And it has been grounded. So this confirmation that you both share this dream to have a new beginning in the 3D. Put it right up here above this, these other two ones. Put it way up here. All right. So, yeah, let me just pause it here and I will do the twin flame aspect. You know what I just realized? I was going to move the cards over. I didn't pull an outcome position, a final outcome for the feminine. My apologies. All right, outcome. Nine of Swords, suffering in silence, sitting on the edge of the precipice. Now, you got the Nine of Pentacles as an outcome for your side. So there's a completion here as well, mirroring. So let me just give these cards a quick shuffle here. Not many left. Five of Pentacles. Whoa, 11-11 calling card. And the Ace of Swords. Awesome. Okay, Five of Pentacles. So there's a sense that she's going to be releasing herself from something. Now, this is a mirrored image of what's going on your side for your final outcome. Okay, so you got the Five of Pentacles as well. Why can't I sit this up? Sorry. So you got the Five of Pentacles. She did as well. So there's that sense that she needs to release something in the 5D. This Pentacles are 5D. So she needs to like shoot herself in the foot in order to be released from this mental prison that she's put herself in. And whereas for you, it's making you feel like you're being left out in the cold. You're feeling helpless, like this little boy, this child. And it's creating a sense of heartbreak and loss, is what I'm now picking up. Even though it's a feminine energy here, you know, it could represent that she's coming towards you broken and needs to be healed, but I'm thinking, you know, because I pulled this as a clarification for these cards, it's really this feeling of being left out in the cold is causing heartbreak and loss, but you cannot deny this Nine of Pentacles and this Eight of Wands. That's that positive energy coming towards you in the future. So over here we have that Nine of Swords. She got it, I think, in her present position. Yes, she got it right here in her present position. But there's an ending to this. It's a nine. It is releasing yourself from that mental prison. And here we got the Eight of Swords. It's the same energy, except for it's an energy coming from the outside. So she has, what I'm getting here is that she shoots herself in the foot, like metaphorically, and releases herself from this mental prison, which ultimately opens that channel for this 1111 connection to come in. So this is my 1111 card, verification that it is a twin flame and it is in her future. But she needs to break free of that prison. All right, so let me put this back. Oh, things are falling apart here. Okay, so now I might as well just do it now. Do the twin flame. So I think I'm going to use the Dorian Virtue Archangel Tarot cards. So let me just give that a quick shuffle, and then I'll use the Osho Zen for clarifiers. Okay, so what is a feminine energy for the union? What is she bringing in? This one, divine guidance, the high priest. I was waiting for you to show up. So you are guiding her towards the union with your being awake and conscious. So this is a high priest. You are here in the 5D when she needs it, guiding her towards her destiny, towards her higher union, towards union. So I'm struggling for words. This one wants. Seven of Cups for the masculine. Time to make a decision. Be clear of what you want and take action and need for detoxification. So this is the energy that you are bringing in. I believe it was in the present position with the Two of Swords. So there's this sense of not really seeing things clearly. The Hierophant, it says, the search for meaning in life. Consider an alternative approach. Surround yourself with wise teachers or friends. So that you're being represented as a spiritual leader that's drawing her. Even though you are feeling confused and lost, Spirit is asking you to own it. It's okay not to know. Allow. Okay, so the foundation. The moon. The opportunity to improve your plans. Listen to your intuition for accurate guidance. Face your fears and grow stronger. So this is the foundation energy. This is the same card that's being is being shown in her present position. So she's going through the dark night of the soul, and you are guiding her through. Sorry, everything's imploding on me here. My apologies. So that's that grounding energy. So where shall I put this? I'll do this. That's foundation. Okay, crowning energy. The Queen of Cups. Kind, understanding, giving, psychic. Follow your heart, a love of home and family, trustworthy psychic information. So, love, being open and receptive to love, is the crowning energy. A give and a take. And, you know, it's a beautiful celebration of love. All right, so for the heart-centered energy, this represents both of you coming together in union. What is that ultimate message? Three of Pentacles. So do what you love, a time of great personal growth in career or artistic endeavors, working with others to in a cooperative manner. So you got this summer with the Three of Pentacles, Three of Wands, and there's something else in between. But I'm sure, yeah, here, the feminine got it in her message from her higher self. It was with the Ace of Wands. So there's a sense of you both wanting to ground this foundation, come together in the 3D world, and have that start together. I'm going to put that here. All right, so I'm going to pull an Osho's End card for each position. And I don't think I'm going to read all of them to you. That just, again, it's too much reading. But I just want to pull clarification for them. Okay, so what additional messages do you have for the High Priest, please? Wow, Ten of Wands again. So that confirms that you are here in the 5D offering her spiritual comfort and that connection while she goes through this phase, this release, this Ten of Wands. She got that in what she's resisting with the Devil card, remember? Okay, so I shall read that one to you because it's very important. It represents what she is experiencing right now and what you are helping her through on a 5D level. The figure on this card is quite literally all tied up in knots. His light still shines within, but he has repressed his own vitality, trying to meet so many demands and expectations. He has given up all of his own power and vision in return for being accepted by the very same forces that have imprisoned him. The danger of suppressing one's natural energy in this way is apparent in the cracks of the volcano eruption about to take place around the edges of the image. The real message of the card is to find a healing outlet for this potential explosion. It is essential to find a way to release whatever tension and stress might be building up inside of you right now. Beat up a pillow, jump up and down, go into the wilderness and scream at the empty sky. Anything to shake up your energy and allow it to circulate freely. Don't wait for the catastrophe to happen. That is why you are in the 5D. Okay, so I'm going to pull a card for the Seven of Cups. Wow, the Ace of Swords again. This keeps showing up in the Twin Flame readings. So I'm going to read it to you if you haven't watched my videos yet. So you're bringing in this clarity of thought, even though you're confused. I think this is the message from Spirit, is to be the observer. Oh, shoot. I forgot what page I'm looking for. Yeah, consciousness. Oops. We come from the unknown and we go on moving into the unknown. We will come again. We have been there thousands of times and we will be there a thousand more times. Our essential being is immortal, but our body, our embodiment is mortal. Our frame is which we are, our houses, the body, the mind. They are all of material things. They will get tired. They will get old. They will die. But your consciousness, for which Buddhahārma used the word no mind, Gautama Buddha has also used the word no mind, is something beyond the body and the mind, something beyond everything. That no mind is eternal. It comes into expression and goes again into the unknown. This movement through the unknown to the known is, and from the known to the unknown continues for eternity unless somebody becomes enlightened. Then that is his last life. This flower will not come back again. The flower that has become aware of itself need not come back to life because life is nothing but a school in which to learn. He has learned the lesson. He is now beyond delusions. He will move from the known for the first time into the unknown, but into the unknowable. Move from the unknown into the unknowable. Stillness, consciousness, clarity of thought, truth. Okay, so for the Moon card, one clarifier for that, please, Spirit. Okay, that one jumped out right at me. Four of Cups, turning in. So this kind of represents the same energy as going in. Here we got a masculine energy going within. Here's a feminine turning in. Consciousness turning in. So you're guiding her to that peaceful state. Four cups. Sorry, I don't want to stop the video. It's one shot that can help it. Okay. Turning inward is not turning in at all. Going inward is not going at all. Turning inward simply means that you have been running after this desire and that. You have been running and running, and you have been coming again and again to frustration. That each desire brings misery, that there is no fulfillment through desire, that you never reach anywhere, that contentment is impossible. Seeing the truth that running after desire takes you nowhere, you stop. Not that you make any effort to stop. If you make an effort to stop, it is again running in a subtle way. You are still desiring. Maybe now it is desireless that you desire. If you are making an effort to go in, you're still going out. Any effort can only take you out, outwards. All journey are outward journeys. There's no inward journey. How can you journey inward? You're already there. There is no point in going. When going stops, journeying disappears. When desiring is no more, clouding your mind, you are in. This is called turning in, but it is not turning in at all. It is simply not going out. So again, it's going in deep beneath the subconscious mind and finding that truth. Okay, so a card for the Queen of Cups. I'm just going to move this over here so you can see it a bit better. I'll just pick from the top. Nine of Cups. Again. Wish granted card. So, again, I'm not going to read it to you, but this is a state of not doing. It is, feeling emotional abundance. Wish granted. Things coming towards you. But if you take it for granted, then there's a sense of things crumbling. So you don't want to be lazy about things and take things for granted. So what I'm getting here is that wish granted. You asked for the Queen of Cups and you see her as your ultimate desire, and that is what will be granted. Crowning energy. All right. So for the Three of Pentacles, and that's a heart-centered energy. Wow, perfect conditioning, devil. That's this card right here. So she's coming into consciousness. She's realizing that she's the lion amongst the sheep. You've already come into your awakening, but you're helping her through that process, which will ultimately ground you guys in the 3D. So conditioning, she is awakening, just as I thought. All right, so now I'm going to pull two cards from, call it Baron Reed, Enchanted Map, and I shall read those to you as the final messages from the universe. Okay, feminine first. Moonlight again. Wow. She got the moon three times. And encouragement. That is so perfect. Thank you, Spirit. You're on the right track. Keep going. And she's the one that's going through the dark night of the soul. Wow, and I opened it right to the page. Further confirmation. Your intuition allows you to see beyond the mundane, logical, and analytical. Follow it. Moonlight beckons. Come and trust your intuition to lead you into places that might not seem logical. Your hunches will be right on target. Resist second-guessing yourself, for your alternative perception is especially sharp right now. You can see beyond the surface of things and truly read between the lines. This is a good time to use oracle cards or other systems of divination to gain information. Remember that the language of intuition is a symbolic one. It comes in subtly through hunches and tingling, a clear sound or an animal or object crossing your path. Spirit is sending you messages to help you now. Success is yours if you follow it. So she's getting signs and synchronicities from Spirit, helping her, guiding her, and from you as well. You are so tapped into the 5D. Are you kidding me? All right, so 54 is the last card in the Call It, Bear, and Read enchanted map. You are receiving a nudge in the right direction. This card tells you that you're being gently encouraged to step into your power, into your dream of your life. New things are out there to be explored, and the nurturing power of the universe is giving you a nudge in the right direction. You will get the help that you need and won't be alone on your quest. Every step you take right now, supported by wisdom of the universe, you are on the right path. Keep going, baby. All right? So I hope this reading helped. I really enjoyed doing it for you. Very complex reading, but I'm pretty sure it answered your question as to why you're not receiving information back. It's because she is going through massive changes while you are awake and you're in a state of rest and peace. So, yeah, don't give up, and abundance is coming your way. 1111 connection, baby. All right, much love. Cheers.